With me in the studio this morning from Verona Pharma, I'm joined by David Ebsworth. David, good morning.
Good morning.
You're chairman of Verona. You joined 5 years ago,
yep.
I believe. What first attracted you?
Well, I heard about it from an ex-colleague of mine who had actually been approached as a potential chairman, and he didn't have the capacity. And since we'd worked on compounds in this area when I was a buyer with this person, I knew a little bit about the area, and I also had met Jan Anders, who was the chief executive, during my time at Bayer. So I gave Jan Anders a call and said, you know, can you put my name in the ring? And I went through the process, and I was very happy to be selected.
And how would you describe how the company's evolved and the progress that's been made in the time since you've been there?
I think we've seen massive progress. When we started, it was really 3 or 4 people. We didn't have a lot of money. We had early data, but we didn't have a large amount of data. And over that 5 years, we've raised significant capital. Mm. We've hired some excellent people to supplement the team. And we've delivered, you know, a number of different clinical trials with about 850 patients, which really show that we have a compound that has massive potential to impact the lives of patients, both with chronic obstructive pulmonary disease, as well as potentially asthma or cystic fibrosis.
And always a difficult question to answer, but is this progress being reflected in the company's market cap?
No.
And in the share price?
No. I'm actually quite disappointed in the current share price. I think that there's a massive upside. Since I joined the company as chairman, I've probably spent £300,000 buying shares, £125,000 of that this year, to demonstrate not only to shareholders but also the whole team my belief in them and in the company and in our program. And I'm convinced that we will see that share price change significantly as we produce more data and as people recognize that these diseases really need a new compound that can impact the lives of patients.
What's the market missing then, in your view?
I don't think they have seen the prevalence of the disease and therefore the number of patients that could potentially be treated with ensifentrine. I don't think they have recognized the quality of the data.
Do you feel that there could be the perception out there around some of the challenges that the smaller biotechs have when trying to make a name for themselves in the wider industry?
I think that's a little bit of it. I mean, we've got a series of first-class healthcare investors as our major investors in the company. And I saw the amount of due diligence that these investors did before they committed multiple millions of pounds or dollars to the company. And, you know, I'm not, for example, an IP lawyer, but they put armies of IP lawyers into the data room. And obviously, they wouldn't have invested if they hadn't given us a clean bill of health. So I'm very comforted by the intellectual property side of the company. The data is massive. We have seen very significant improvement in the symptoms of patients over, you know, a 4-week period of time where it continues to improve the symptoms for them. COPD is an incurable disease today. Mm. We are not putting forward a cure, but we think we can have a massive impact on the quality of life of these patients as they deal with the symptoms that they suffer from.
Are you up against many others in the space looking to come up with similar treatments?
There are not many companies working on fundamental new treatments for respiratory diseases. So we're a little bit of on the sideline, and there's not a lot of noise and hype around a company in that particular area. But on the other hand, there are no other fundamental new therapies besides ours in this area.
And I suppose to that point, it makes it hard to compare you.
Yes.
In this space.
There are very few clear comparables.
You mentioned a moment ago about the team. Of course, having the right people in place is key.
Yeah.
Who have you got?
Well, we've got, obviously, Jan Anders Carlson, our chief executive, Piers Morgan, our CFO, that are based here. Mm. But our clinical team is primarily based in the United States. Kathy, who runs the clinical program, is a very experienced physician. She has taken numerous drugs through the FDA in this therapeutic area. has a massive amount of experience. Desiree, our head of regulatory affairs, recently got the approval for also for other respiratory drugs in slightly different indications for a major pharmaceutical company. So we've actually got a series of, I'll say, very powerful ladies, if I can phrase it that way, who know this area inside and out, and really know the right way to take the drug forward.
So what's next then for Verona, and what are you hoping is going to move the needle?
We have a major clinical trial that's likely to report towards the end of the year, and that's a 400 patient trial looking at a series of different doses of ensifentrin on the background of one of the current medicines that are used. And we hope to be able to demonstrate in this particular trial that not only do we have a powerful effect on the lungs, that the lungs expand properly and we improve the lung function, but that we have a strong effect over those 4 weeks on the symptoms of the patients.
David, good to meet you this morning. Thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you very much.